मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर धवल चंदा राणा, एंड टूडे वी विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द पॉइंट ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 3 नोन एज अ रिलेशनल क्वेरी लैंग्वेज. टूडेज टॉपिक इज, फर्स्ट वी गो थ्रू द रिवाइज टॉपिक ऑफ बेसिक रिलेशनल अलजेब्रा ऑपरेशंस विच वी आर डिस्कस इन आर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. टूडेज we are focusing on the two different operation of a relational algebra known as a combined selection and projection operation, and the second one, it is known as a Cartesian product. Before we will start today's topic, I will just revise a basic structures of relational algebra operation. There are lots of operation we will discuss in our previous lecture. Same thing we will discuss in today's starting point. So you can just remember that the different relational operations, or we can say relational algebra operation, start with the selection operation which we are studying in previous lecture. A selection operation, whenever we require a display a particular rows, or we can say record, or we can say a tuple from a relation, or we can say a table, at that time we are using a selection operation. Second operation, also we are go through this in previous lecture, it is known as a projection operation. Whenever a user want to display a particular column from a relation, means there are lots of attributes in a particular relation, or we can say column. Whenever end user requires some of the columns from the groups of column, at that time we are using a projection operation. Both the operation we are study with the example in our previous lecture. So if you have any doubt regarding selection operation and a projection operation, please go through my previous video. Third one, it is known as a cross product, which we are study in today's video lecture, as well as a next known as a division operator. First we are going with the combinations of selection and projection operation, how we are using a selection and projection operation with a single query. And the second one, it is known as a cross product, both the operation we are studying in today's lecture. So first we know that what is a cross product. Whenever a end user multiple each tuples of both the relations, means actual contentions of a relational algebra or actual concept of relational algebra starting with the cross product, means some users wants record from multiple tables on a single time, at that time we are using a cross product. Next one, it is known as a division operator. Divide one relation by another. Same thing, but we are performing some another way to represent output from a multiple table. At that time, we are using a division operator. Rename operator, whenever user want to update a table name, or we can say attribute name, or both the way, if user want to update attributes name as well as relational name, at that time we are using a rename operator. Join, whenever a user want to retrieve a multiple data from the multiple relation, means a combinations data of a records from two or more tables, at that time we are using a natural join, or we can say inner join, or known as a outer join. In the outer join, there are the three different types known as a left outer, right outer join, and full outer join. And the last one, it is known as a set operator. Combine the result of two query into a single results, means it is known as a concept of subquery. At a particular time, user want to perform only single query, but the output depends on a multiple query. So the combinations of multiple query retrieve a single query and provide the records based on a set operator. There are three different types of set operator known as a union, intersection, and a minus, or we can say set differences. So it is the basic summary which we have studied in our previous video lecture as well as today's lecture, because it is the important concept that we need to remember that all the operations will be part of this particular unit. So today we will start with the combinations of selection projections operation, and second point, which is known as a cross product. So start with the combination projection and selection operation with the example. Display the roll number, name, and branch of ME branch student. In the below mentioned relation, known as a student relation, there are four columns known as a roll number, name, branch and SPI. User want to only retrieve a particular records known as a ME branch. So at that time, we are using a combinations of selection as well as a projection operation. Because user want to a record based on a selections condition, it is known as a ME branch, and they want only three attributes among the sets of four attributes. So we are using projection as well as a selection operation. Start with the selection, user want to retrieve only those record which belongs to ME branch. So first we put a condition based on selection operation, sigma branch is equal to ME from a student relation. But user want to only three column known as a roll number, name and branch. So at that time we are using a projection operations. So based on output, a sigma branch is equal to ME, they provide all the columns known as a roll number, name, branch and SPI. But as per the example says, a user want to display only the roll number, name and branch column. At that time, we required a projection operation. So it is the projection operation with help of a roll number, name and branch column. And a second condition, retrieve only those record who are belong to the ME branch. So as per the final output, as per the example says, a display roll number, name and branch, you can easily say that it is a final output of a particular example. Display roll number, name and branch of ME branch student. So as of the below table, we perform first a selection operation. Based on selection operation, we perform a particular attribute. So we are using a projection operation. And final output is known as roll number, name and branch of a particular ME branch. So I hope you are clear how we are using a combinations of projection and selection operation. Let's see some another example. Example says this, a display a name, branch and SPI of student whose SPI is more than 8. So first we provide a conditions known as a selection operation. We apply find out the student whose SPI is more than 8. Among the all the student, first we provide a result to generate a SPI is more than 8. So select SPI is greater than 8 based on a student relation. Now user want to only three column known as a name, branch and SPI. They omitting a roll number column. So at that time we are using a projection operation. Based on the output 1, we find some combinations with the projection and selection operation, and finally we get the belowing output. So it is the way we are using a combined use of projection and selection. And if you want to any doubt regarding projection and selection operation, please go through my previous video. It is really helpful to understand how the projection operation work and how the selection operation work. Let's say some another example. Display the name, branch and SPI of student whose belong to C branch and SPI is more than 8. So there are requirement of two condition. First, we need to find out a branch particularly belongs to C, as well as on the C branch a student required to getting SPI more than 8. And after the combinations of two selection operation, student want to only those record, only those attributes known as a name, branch and SPI. Means they not required a roll number. Let's see how the particular thing is work. First we find out a select a branch known as C, and use of AND operator find the SPI is greater than 8 and provide the condition on a student relation. Requirement of operations known as a projection, because a display only three columns known as a name, branch and SPI. So we are using only three attributes with help of a projection operation. So finally we are getting only single records, because as you know that there are two students, Raj and Puneet, both are belong to C student, but we require to find out whose student who are belong to C, but SPI is more than 8. So Raj is omitted because of second condition. So I hope you are clear. Next example, display name of student along with their branch, who belongs to ME branch or electrical, or we can say EE branch. So user want to retrieve those student information require only name and branch who are belong to ME or EE branch. So we provide a OR condition with a selection operations, branch ME or it is known as a OR symbol or OR condition, or belong to EE or no, belong to a student relation. And user display only two information among the four known as name and branch name. So we just provide a two attributes with the help of projection operations. So as per the apply the particular relational algebra operation, we getting results known as a Meet belongs to ME and Jatin belongs to EE branch. And the second point, we will study a Cartesian product, or we can say cross product. A symbol cross product, we are using a cross mark. Notation relation 1 base to R1 and relation 2, it is known as R2, because a Cartesian product is used whenever user want to retrieve a combinations of a two relations as well as retrieve informations belongs to a multiple relation. At that time user want to use a Cartesian product, or we can say a cross product operation. It will multiply each tuples of a relation 1 to each tuples of a relation 2. As per the discussion, whenever we use a Cartesian product, at that time output is generated based on multiplying each tuples of relation 1 to each tuples of multiple relation with a 2. Now we can see with the example. First we discuss attributes of relation, or we can say resultant relations. It is known as attributes of R1 plus R2. Means finally the numbers of results, or we can say numbers of column retrieved based on relation 1 R1 plus attributes of relation R2. Means whenever we apply a cross product, or we can say Cartesian product, we getting summations of attributes of both the relation. And a tuple of resultant relation is a multiplication of R1 as well as R2, because it is definitely say that a multiplying of each tuple of R1 to each tuples of R2. So that's why a resultants of tuple relation, it is known as a tuples of R1 multiplication with R2. Let's see with the example, so you can easily understand how the attributes and tuples will be resultant as a Cartesian product or a cross product. Start with the example. There are the two relations known as a student. In student table, there are the three attributes known as a roll number, name and branch. In a second relation, or we can say R2 relation, it is known as a result. There are the two attributes known as a roll number and SPI. As per the use of Cartesian product, we know that a student cross the result because we are using a cross product. So as per the previous slides, we easily says that attributes known as a relation R1 attributes plus relation R2 attribute. So in a relation R, or you can say student table, there are the three attributes known as a student roll number, name and branch, plus result attributes roll number and SPI. It is known as a result of roll number and SPI. So we can getting our attribute resultants. Now we find out total number of records, or we can say resultants of tuples. First, multiplying of each relations with another relation. So first we start with the 101, multiplying with the 101 resultant. Second thing, multiplying 101 with the second relation known as a 103. Same thing, R2 multiplying with the resultant relation 101, it is known as a third relation 102 meet. And a combinations of multiplying 102 with the multiplication of 103, it is the generate of fourth tuples known as a R02, or we can say fourth attributes. So there are four numbers of tuples generated amongst the student and resultant relation, and we getting a total number of five attributes, because summations of attribute, it is the resultant attribute, and multiplication of tuples, it is known as a resultant tuples. So if both the relation have some attribute with the same name, it can be distinguished by the combining relation name dot attributes name. Means roll number attributes are a common in a both the relation. So based on a requirement, whenever we using a Cartesian product, we are defining with help of a relation name dot roll number, or we can say relation name dot common attributes, same as a relation name dot as attribute name. So based on requirement of identification, we can easily identify with help of relation name dot attributes name. I hope you are understand how the Cartesian products and cross product is work. Student number, it is the common attributes, so we can using this way. I will give you some another example of Cartesian product, or we can say cross product. Example known as the same with a student and result. There are the fourth number of attributes in a relation table student and a four number of attributes in a resultant table. Find out the result of roll number and name of student table and find out a projection operation with help of roll number, SPI and backlog of a resultant relations. So as per the example, we getting a roll number as a common column, so we can apply a relation name dot roll number as attribute and relation name dot as a attribute name. Second, let's see some another example of Cartesian product and cross product. Example same it is, but we are just adding some numbers of tuples. Select a branch belongs to C and semester of 3 of student relation. Cross product with the selections of SPI is greater than 7 and a backlog is less than 0 of resultant table. So student retrieve only those informations who have a branch C and a semester 3 and SPI is greater than 7 and backlog is less than 1. So at that time we are requiring a combinations of two relation known as a student and result. With help of two combination, we getting final output. So based on the first 101 and 103, both are satisfies below condition, like branch is C and SEM is 3. Now second condition, SPI is greater than 7 and backlog is less than 1, satisfy only one tuples known as a 103. Now the combination of both the relation, we getting the final output known as a 101 multiplication with the 103 known as a 101 Raj branch C SEM 3 with help of roll number 103 SPI 9 backlog 0 and rank 1. Now see with the 103 name Om branch C semester 3 with combination solve multiplication with the resultant 103 9 SPI and backlog is 0 and rank is 1. So I hope you are understand how the thing will be retrieved with help of multiple two relation. I hope here is example you are easy to understand then how the Cartesian product and all we can say cross product will be work. Thank you so much.